traditional news weather models, we only consider the marginal cost and marginal revenue. However, it's very open to see the we would have the fixed cost, so called the setup cost. So if the T of Q original in this one, pound K. So if we have the setup cost, so how much we are going to order? We increase the G of Q to G of Q plus the setup cost. Actually, the optimum point remain at the Q star. When we define the Q star, the new notation is capital S. So what is the X axis? Is initial on-hand inventory. Actually, this line is a preposition for the multi-period problem. Okay. If anything left over at the end of the periods is eligible for sale into the next period, okay? So we will consider the so-called initial on-hand inventory. Okay, if we have initial inventory label defined as I, okay? So we will have to the this number to here, they are equivalent, right? So we will get the little s. How to get the little s? This G of S capital S plus K equal to G of little s. And little s is less than capital S. So if in this period, we already have, for example, this is little s equal to 5, and capital S is equal to 10. So if we have inventory, initial inventory I equal to 6, for example. So what is the expected cost? We are here, right? Understood? It's me? Right. So if we buy nothing, okay, this is the expected cost we can get, right? Okay, but if we buy anything, so instead of the original cost G of Q, we need to pay for positive set of costs. Okay, so this number is always lower than any number for the new function, right? So are we going to order anything? No, right? Okay. Which implies as long as initial inventory is larger than little s, okay? We just stay there, do nothing. We are not order anything, right? So in this case, only for what? The initial inventory is less than little s. For example, I equal to 2. We are here, right? Okay. If we order up to capital S, we will bring the cost from here down to here, right? Okay. Any questions? So the optimal cost without the set of cost, as long as inventory is less than k equal to 0, as long as the inventory is less than capital S, we buy things up to capital S, right? But now, since we have the inventory, we have the set of cost. Originally, if if inventory is with setup cost equal to 0. If inventory is less than capital S, okay, so order quantity is what? Is equal to what? Capital S, the difference between the capital S and the initial inventory, right? We will bring the inventory label from here to here to get the minimum cost, right? So the C of so then the C of I equal to what? Equal to G of S as long as I less than capital S, right? Or what? I larger or equal to capital S. We stay there, right? So what is C of I in that case? So this is C of I. If our initial inventory is larger than capital S, we are not going to buy anything, right? We just stay here, okay? If our initial inventory is less than capital S, we bring the inventory to capital S, right? So this is so-called the order up to policy. Order up to what? Capital S. order up to. I must incidentally remove this slide. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, I had the slide. Yeah, the slide here. That's okay. So if in case of this k larger than zero, so we are here, right? So if I less than capital S, since we are here, okay, we have 2 points. One is little s, the other one is capital S. Okay. So if inventory is less than little s, sorry, this is not the this is not Q star, order quantity. Order quantity, okay. Order quantity. Otherwise, there's kind of confusion about this one and the previous one. Okay. The order quantity. So the order quantity. Equal to what? Q star, sorry, capital S minus 1, inventory label. Okay? So if I is larger than little s, but order quantity. Equal to zero. Right? Order zero. Since we stay here, stay here, stay here, stay here, stay here. Okay. So based on this one, the optimal order quantity is in this guy. Here. So for the so what is the result for the C of I? This guy is here, right? As long as the initial inventory is less than little s, we bring the inventory cost here, right? Okay, so this is label, this is label. And then what? We stay at the original inventory labels. Okay. So this one is k larger than zero. And the green one is cell cost equal to zero. Thank you. see this one is so-called the order up to S powers. That's only so-called the, this is what, critical number. So we may say there's a so-called a single critical number of powers. Single critical number of powers. Can you read this?
Okay, that will be better.
So this is called the repeat number. So with k larger than 0, there are two critical numbers, right? So this is so-called the two critical number powers. So this is so called S powers. Remind you, for the first, maybe during the first two sessions of this course, right? I told you that, for example, in the 7-Eleven, we checked the product left over in the shelf. If the number is less than 5, okay, we order up to 10, right? Right? Okay? So that's so-called the SS policy. That's two critical numbers. One is what? 5, the other one is 10, okay? So the order size is what? Capital S, the difference between the capital S and the inventory label, okay? Because there's always a set of costs. We're not trying to buy only one single unit. That might be way too expensive. Then in the later slide, I will argue the difference between the capital 2S, capital S and the little s. We may say is what? Minimum number of the product to order, right? There's a minimum number. What is that? Economic scale. We at least need to buy 5 of them, okay? Right? Otherwise, we are not going to buy anything. You see? That's so-called economic scale, right? That's the next slide. Now we have an argument here. Can I erase this one? Are you ready to write down? Write it down? It's okay? Now we are talking about so-called convex analysis. So if we have two functions f and g, we say they are both convex, means what? The second derivative larger than zero, right? Okay. So what happens for a plus g? It's also convex, right? So what if one of them is not convex? Well, then we won't have any further clue, right? We don't know. One is convex, the other one is concave. What happened for them? Well, it's hard to tell. It's hard to tell. So if we are lucky, we have the two functions that are both convex. Okay. So the sum of them are convex. How about the difference between of them? Well, some problem. We don't know. We don't know. So only thing is somehow it's like a convex plus a convex. Okay, the behavior of the function still remain convex. Okay, so you see, how about the green function? It's convex. Green, well, second, green is convex. How about the blue one? By definition of the convex is if we line up the two points, all the points within the graph, they are convex. So this one is okay. So how about blue one? No, right? If we pick up this one and this one, well, this one. Okay, if we pick up this one, pick up on this side. Okay, inside, it's not convex. Oh, two lines, two points here. These two, right? So this, in this edge, is outside the graph, right? I mean, this is the inside. Which is outside, right? Some of them inside, some of them outside, right? You see, there's two points. Okay. Now we are ready to introduce the so-called second period problem. Okay. For the second period problem, everything is based on the result of the first step. Okay. So in the second period problem, so what is the definition of the delta of Q2? Now in the second period, okay, the substrate represented the what? The period. Okay. So delta Q2, if Q2 will order nothing, so how much we need to pay for the setup? Zero, right? If we order anything, we need to pay for the setup cost. Okay? So the total cost will be the setup cost plus the, this is so-called the, what? Expected cost for period two. Okay, so in the previous analysis, what is G of Q is expected cost for period one, right? Okay. So then we also would have the expected cost for period two, right? With respect to what? The overage and underage cost. Right? Okay? So what happened in period one for this one is repeat in period two. Depends on initial inventory in period two plus the order quantity. Right? Since we define the initial inventory for period one is zero, okay, then we will have simply the notation as G of Q, right? So now we will definitely have the inventory for beginning inventory for period two. Okay, you may wonder. Okay, is there anybody wonder about the great in the previous slides. So this is the initial inventory, right? Okay. How about the initial inventory is negative? It doesn't matter. Remind you, in EOQ model, we have the case with the back order, right? Okay, no problem. Initial inventory could be zero, could be negative. No problem. So this is a kind of most general case. We may incorporate the case with the back order. Okay. In this class, I'm not going to show you about that. It's way too complicated. Okay, so how about this guy? See, if the setup cost in the first period is zero, we know the C1 is convex, right? Okay, so this is what the integration of the convex function. Actually, integration is what? Spatial representation for the sum, right? Okay. Integration is a special case for the sum, right? So actually, this is the sum of the convex sum function, okay? So as long as C1 is convex, so this term, after the integration, the derivative, second derivative is larger than zero. No doubt. Okay, and we also show G of G function is convex, right? Agree? We just show, right? Yeah. G function is convex larger than zero, right? Okay. function convex, okay? So if the set of costs in period 1 is 0, so C1 is convex. So the integration over the C1 function is also convex. And this one definitely convex. So we have one convex function plus another convex function. So this term is convex, right? I mean the last two terms. Then we have a problem for this one. If fortunately K2 is also 0, okay? So this is a convex function, right? Then we take the first and second derivative of it. So the second derivative is larger than 0, right? So by setting the first order transition of the second two terms, we will get the Q2 star. No problem, right? The same mechanism. Duplicative process in the period 1. Any questions?
我用中文讲一遍了，这个听不懂啊，很麻烦的。
Sorry, I need to use Mandarin a little bit. Yeah. 那个，它是刚刚有提到嘛，啊，这个是 convex， 对不对？因为它的二次微分大于零嘛，是不是？好，那关键是它了。那我们知道 C1 如果 K1 等于零的话，在